I'm George Blaha, and this is the From Glory Days Show, which chronicles the lives of professional Detroit athletes following their pro sports careers. Watch the stories unfold as former Detroit Pistons, Tigers, Red Wings, and Lions share their personal stories of struggle and success as they have transitioned from the pinnacle of their pro sports careers back into normal everyday lives. You won't find another show like the From Glory Days show, capturing this transition as told directly by the athletes themselves.
Hello, I'm Kurt David, author of the best-selling book, From Glory Days, and your host of the From Glory Days show. Today's guest was a high school and collegiate All-American in football. Following his first-round draft pick by the Detroit Lions, he finished his eight-year NFL career with the Colts, where he received the Unsung Hero Award after winning Super Bowl V. Let's give a nice warm welcome to our guest, Tom Nowatzke. Tom, thanks for being on the show tonight, and very excited to have you here. Obviously, we have some history just from talking in the past, but one of the my first impression of you when I met you was the size of your hands. I just was overly overwhelmed by the size of your hands, and more importantly, that Super Bowl ring that's on your finger there. What size finger is it again? What size ring?
15.
Size 15.
15 and a half, actually.
15, that could fit my big toe, I guess. Yeah. So, known for your meaty paws, and I classify your hands as, you know, we have white-collar hands and we have blue-collar hands. There's not a question in my mind that those are some blue-collar hands that have worked together.
I always say I have these hands because I had to milk 6 cows in the morning and at night when I was a kid.
So that's how they got that way then.
Yeah.
Yep, that was before the modern times with cow milking and
yes,
everything.
Yes.
But let's talk about that career. Let's talk about the football that's in your life and actually kind of backing up a little bit through high school. You actually had a pretty good career in basketball and football, or some good sports for you.
Yes, I didn't start playing football until I was a freshman. And I did play basketball and track and football.
Mm-hmm. When did you realize that football was going to be your ticket? Towards the latter part of your high school?
My junior year, my senior year, and I started getting offers from various colleges. And none of my family has gone to college, and none of my kids in the high school have gone to college, really. And it was kind of foreign, and I ended up at Indiana.
Yeah, and in fact, making that choice to go to Indiana, there was some decision-making that had to happen at that point to go to Indiana. Before that, you had many offers from other Big Ten schools as well, Illinois, Michigan, and in fact, closer to home here in Michigan, one of the reasons why you didn't go to Michigan was because they wanted to do something to you.
Bump Elliott wanted to put me at a tight end, and if I would have had changed any decision in my career, I probably should have taken that offer.
Yeah, for two reasons. One is to play tight end. Two is to come to Michigan, right?
Currently, yes. I didn't have any idea. Number one, I was going to play in the pros. And if I had tight end, I could have played an extra 6 years.
Sure. Had a longevity versus a fullback that's getting beat on all the time. Also, at Illinois, that was one of the options you had, and they had a great player that came out of Illinois at that time
as well. I loved Pete Elliott, who was the head coach. And if I'd have went there at the time, I'd have been playing with Dick Butkus.
Yeah, you and Dick would have been teammates. Imagine that. Guys on both ends of the field there.
We were teammates once. Two All-American games, we were teammates.
Was that after college, was
yes,
it?
Okay. College.
Yeah, and so you went through your college years, high school All-American, college All-American. At what point did you realize that there might be a future? You mentioned that you didn't really know that pro football was an option for you, but at what point did you start realizing that pro football might be an option for you?
I didn't really plan on it until late in my junior year at college because I was in ROTC and I was signed up to go to Vietnam as a first lieutenant, and I backed out of that at the last minute, and they threatened all kinds of stuff with me at the ROTC. And so I was getting letters from the NFL, and I decided I didn't want to commit for 4 years in the military.
So at that point, you were looking, not even looking at pro football, you were looking at officer school and thus going into the military at that point.
Yes.
And as a result, when you started getting those letters, all of a sudden you realized, hey, maybe there is a shot at it here. And I think you had a story about that, too, that you had some phone calls from one of the ROTC guys about what was going to happen or how come you didn't show up for a meeting.
I missed a meeting to sign up, and they got a call, and they said the commandant wanted me to come in and see him, and he threatened me. He said, you know, if you don't sign up, we're going to move you to the top of the list. And I said, well, you have to do what you have to do, but I'm not going to commit myself for 4 years in the military when I maybe go this other route.
Yeah.
And if I got moved to the top of the list, I didn't know about it.
You didn't get that draft anyway. Instead, you actually got two other drafts. Kind of unique situation, Tom. You had a situation where when you were drafted, at that time, and correct me if I'm wrong, but it was the first time that they had a dual draft like that, where they had a draft in the NFL and then also at that time the AFL. Is that correct?
Well, there were two separate leagues, and the AFL was a startup league, and they wanted to raid all the NFL draft choices. Mm. And at the time, my last 3 weeks on campus before this Thanksgiving, they had an NFL babysitter and an AFL babysitter watching me, as they did in other cities. Mm-hmm. And they followed us to New York for the coach
was it All-American?
The All-American show, mm-hmm. with Ed Sullivan. Mm-hmm. And the fact that Dick Pollard sat right next to me on a plane to Chicago, and when I got there, I said, Dick, I said, I don't want to tell you this, but when we get there, George Sauer is going to meet me at the airport.
From the Jets.
From the Jets. Mm-hmm. And they whisked me past Dick Pollard down to Sonny Wibblin's limousine and off to Sage Stadium we go. And they made me an hour late for our meeting with the NFL team, so, or the All-American team.
So you're out there, you're checking out New York, you're checking out the Jets. You had scouts from both teams that were recording you, so to speak, out there with the other All-Americans, some great names, actually, at that time. Dick Butkus, Gale Sayers were with you out there for
Craig
that
Morton,
All-American.
Craig Morton, Jack Snow, who's passed away. Mm-hmm. I could have used your agent at the time, because I didn't have an agent. I was there by myself at Chase Stadium, and they wouldn't let me go.
Could have really negotiated at that point. Yeah. Well, I got a good one if you need one, no question about that. But one of the things that helped make your decision, what made your decision between New York and the Lions? I mean, you got drafted by both, the Detroit Lions and the NFL, the New York Jets and the AFL at that time. What helped make that decision for you?
Well, you have to go back to the time, okay? When I was a kid, we didn't have TV. The first TV was black and white, and the only games you saw were the Lions and the Packers on Thanksgiving Day. You didn't see games, okay? Mm-hmm. It wasn't until my second year in the league that they had regional games, and then it got better after that. So why would you not want to go play with Joe Schmidt in the champion Lions, because they had a champion team at the
time.
Now,
was Joe playing at that time?
Joe was playing.
He was still playing.
When I got drafted, he had a sore shoulder. I thought I was drafted to replace him because I played both linebacker and running back. Mm-hmm. But in the end, I replaced Nick Pertesani at fullback. Mm-hmm. And then George Wilson, who was the coach, left that summer that I got drafted, and Harry Gilmer became the coach. So I went through two coaching changes here, Harry mm-hmm. Gilmer and then Joe Schmidt.
Mm-hmm. And when you got there, I mean, that decision to make it was based on the tradition that they had at that point, the 57 championship, and Joe Schmidt was there, obviously MVP of the NFL during that time, and had a great career, and so it was a nice draw for you. In fact, Dick Butkus as well made a decision not to sign with the New York Jets. He decided to sign somewhere else. And if I remember the story right, as a result of you guys going somewhere else, the Jets were able to acquire somebody that year.
Yeah, Dick and I were both drafted by the Jets, mm-hmm. and we both said no. They traded Dick to Denver to get their number one, and then they drafted Namath.
As a result, they were able to take care of Joe Namath at that point.
Yes.
And had the money to be able to pay his salary that year.
Looking back, I was real close to all that money in New York. I never.
If you would have known, but yeah. Well, a couple things.
Maybe I had a good agent.
There you go. You got to go back to that again. But yeah. So you came to Detroit. Obviously, had some good years here as far as your personal career. Had some injuries and things to deal with. And what were some of the peaks of your career as a Lion, a Detroit Lion?
Oh, I think starting my second year, because back then rookies didn't start as rookies. Mm-hmm. They didn't do that. The biggest problem with the Lions is we had no offensive line. Mm-hmm. I mean, just none. We had a great defense, and we won 5 to 7 games a year, and we were 9-4-1 the year before I left Detroit, mm-hmm. which was
we'd take that right now.
It'd be great right now.
Yeah, we'd take that.
Well, back then there weren't playoffs either. You had to win the whole thing in order to get in the playoffs.
Mm. Okay, so win the whole thing as far as your division, or how?
Yes, for your division.
Okay.
Yes.
And so at that point, you had some good seasons there. What happened as far as towards the late? You were here in 5 seasons, if I remember correctly, that you played for the Lions 5 seasons. Towards the latter part, what happened at the time with the Lions was soon to be over?
Well, Joe Schmidt asked me in my third year to switch from running back to linebacker to back up Mike Lucci, and mm-hmm. then I hurt my neck. I crushed the vertebrae in my 4th and 5th vertebrae.
Actually broke it then, basically.
Well, yeah, mm-hmm. and I was out for 12 weeks. I came back and played the last 3 games of that season. Mm-hmm. Came back the next year. And I was playing linebacker again, and they released me because I didn't have the experience at linebacker.
So in other words, the Detroit Lions released you at that point.
And, yes.
And so you were without a job, without a team, kind of wandering a little bit, made some phone calls, but something good happened as a result.
Well, I was working for Clark Equipment Company selling equipment, and all of us had to work back then. Mm-hmm. And I quit, actually. Said I quit. And then one day my wife said, you better call some people. So I did. I was either going to Minnesota, Baltimore, or Chicago. Mm-hmm. And I called and bluffed Baltimore, and they wanted me to wait until after the first season game. And I said, no, I'm going to go this weekend. And they called me back and said, we want you in Baltimore.
So basically you said, hey, if you don't sign me now, I'm going to go somewhere else at this point. So they got you up there in Baltimore. So you got released from Detroit, ended up in Baltimore with the Colts. Not a bad team at that time. Not a bad team whatsoever.
They had a lot of history there. They won this. They were in Super Bowl 68. They should have won that game. They were a good team. But when I went there, the first meeting I went to, they threw the coaches out, and the players were bitching at each other about what was wrong with the team, and I thought maybe I should go back to Detroit.
Like, what am I doing here?
Yeah, it was one